Okay, everyone, so here's a 30-day update on my hair. So, as you all know from the last video, I got a hair transplant, and it's been just over 30 days now. As you can see, I can start wearing hats now, loosely fitted, as long as you got approved by your doctor and everything to make sure that the sides have healed. Now, throughout this, I'll be posting some photos to show you exactly what the sides of my head and the top of my head looks like. Now, in the first 30 days are probably some of the most important because your head's healing and everything's closing up. Your body's trying to figure out what's going on. There's new follicles at the top and just a lot of change happening. Now, a lot is going on still here. And what's helped me a lot is taking the finasteride and the minoxidil. You'll be prescribed that. The minoxidil you'll use one time until it finishes out. I want to say it's about, I have it here. I want to say it's a 90 days. Maybe 60 days worth, and then the finasteride I'll take continuously, as we spoke about in the last video. So what happens in the first month is you're going to go through what's called shock loss. Technically it's the first 3 months, but I think it depends on a lot of your health, age, a lot of factors, you know. So let me show you exactly what's going on here. As you can see, the sides of my head have healed almost fully. I would say fully personally, actually. No more itching, no more nothing like that. The hair's grown very, very fast back out. The top, as you can see, the hair has started to fall out. Now, what's amazing is they gave me these sheets to talk about exactly 2 to 4 weeks, 3 months, things like that. So in the first 3 months, it says here that virtually all the transplanted hairs will be expected to fall out because it's called, they've been traumatized by their relocation. And that's called shock loss. And that's expected. So I think I've already experienced that personally, but so far there's no more itching. I still use the baby shampoo that they gave me with Johnson & Johnson because it does just feel better overall. It does itch here and there, but I think that's part of the healing process. Now, it feels like I got this done so much like farther back in time, but it's literally only been 30 days. Just over 30 days, to be honest. So I shouldn't really see hair growth until about 3 to 6 months is what it, like, a lot of the documentation is saying. But I think because I'm younger and healthier, I should see it much faster. I got back on my routine of working out finally. I got into my routine of, like, you know, just back to normal life. Now, I know some people have asked, was it worth it? And the answer to that is 100% yes. There's a light at the end of the tunnel. Now, it does suck not to be able to be active, things like that. But at the end of the day, it's going to be so worth it. So I definitely recommend anybody who's thought about this to just ask questions, get a consultation, take a look, research, watch videos, ask me questions. Because at the end of the day, I have no regrets on this and I am very, very happy with what's going on with it. All right. So if you guys have any more questions, just holler in the comments. You have my number. You can text me. You can call Chris. I'm going to put his number in the description below here. Please let us know if you have anything else, all right? We'll catch you for the next update. Stay sweet. Bye.